creation of first corporation to take over the world. Worst crime in human history. Written by a truth soldier. danieltowsey.wordpress.com. Okay, this is going to be a really upsetting and enlightening piece of occult knowledge for the sheeple. Do not read this if you know everything the corporate state has taught you and are very happy being a financial slave. In this article you will learn the hidden truth and the core of all evil. You will find many links to documentary videos and informative websites at the bottom of this article to verify for yourself that everything I am about to show you is horribly true. Now here's a thought for those of you who do not believe that organized conspiracies exist. The first thing you need to understand is that the first rule in being a member of a corporation is that you have to sign a conspiracy contract. You must sign this contract to agree to never reveal to anyone, be it the people's government or anyone else, about the immoral and illegal activities of the corporation you are now seeking employment with. This secrecy non-disclosure agreement is essentially a crime syndicate agreement. Years ago, free societies had companies that were honorable contributing members of society. These companies had to abide to all fair and just practices of the society they operated in. Today it is almost impossible to find any companies. Companies means the company you keep. Today we only have conspirators. The free internet has afforded a small temporary window of opportunity for good, caring, concerned individuals to learn the truth. Without the knowledge of truth, there can be no justice or liberty. After all, truth is the most powerful weapon on earth. But the power of truth has really diminished in our society. People today do not want to know or believe anything that is outside of the social engineering that the corporations have done to your thinking. I am about to open your mind to the horrible truths of what is really happening. This is going to be a real shocker for most. I doubt that many will continue reading this article to the end and continue on to deprogram themselves and learn the occult truth. I feel that most will just be too afraid of the truth. Remember, truth is always more bizarre than any fiction you'll ever read. Huge corporations have a never-ending supply of free cash and can create any beautiful and wonderful corporate image they choose for you to believe. Employees of corporations love these images. They live their whole lives living in complete bliss and ignorance to the truth. As you are about to understand, the creation of the first corporation has created a most horrible path of human evolution, or I should say de-evolution. To be able to fully understand, you'll have to seek to understand the most basic of truths. The situation today has become so complicated that people cannot see or understand the very basic truths. The corporate states has effectively made truth a dirty word. It has labeled those that seek to live their lives by truth as kooks and lunatics to be avoided. Please read my article, The Village Idiot, to expand your understanding. One day when you come to realize the evil of corporations, you might want to call in sick. Please read my article, I called in sick. I have spent my whole life being a truth soldier. Please read my A Truth Soldier article. I choose to live by seeking and speaking the truth because I long ago realized that the opposite of truth is insanity. When I was a child, I discovered that truth will make me smart and that doing the opposite would only make me be an idiot. But I soon discovered that the path of truth is a very painful one, and I began my lifelong research to try and understand why the society I live in does not seek the path of truth. I soon began to understand that truth is power and that society has been deliberately dumbed down by corporate media social engineering. I just could not understand why people were not seeking the most rewarding path in their existence, and that is the pursuit of truth, for without truth there cannot be any love of anything. And as you can see, if you look beyond the social engineering, you discover that all that matters, such as human heritage, our environment, and our very planet, is being destroyed by the very effects of the first corporation created. Bear with me while I elaborate more on the effects of the first corporation. You will see and understand that I had to keep you hanging on, for the truth is so horrible that I have to slowly bring you to understand it. I am a truth soldier because when the seeds of truth are sown, the grassroots truth revolution will blossom from the enlightenment. As a result of the creation of the first corporation, society has evolved further and further from all that is naturally beautiful and further towards the totally deceptive corporate image. Today people are totally self-absorbed and selfish. They only care about what appears to be and not what really is. They have been turned into what is termed consumers. They have sold their souls. I discovered how true this is the other day. After I left my local luxury indoor mega mall, as I walked around, all I saw was every imaginable extravagance of self you can imagine. All the shops were totally over-luxurious. I wondered just how is it possible for them to be so. I soon discovered that all products sold were imported from very poor countries who produced these products by economic slaves. I learned that corporate retailers actually mark up their products by as much as 8,000%. I then understood how they could have all this luxury. It's at the expense of what we call third world slave shop workers. This realization made me sick to my stomach. When I realized that huge unfairness, I live in Nova Scotia, Canada, and one day I began to ask people I met, how is it possible that so many here live such a luxurious and easy life from all the products brought into our province? Because I told them that Nova Scotia does not export any finished and manufactured products to the rest of the world. Nova Scotia exports almost nothing made here. The following will prepare you to understand why I named this article as I did. We are almost there. I will soon tell you this horrible truth, but first I will attempt to give you a couple more examples of the dreadful situation this planet is really in, and then you will understand my title of my article. But be sure to watch the documentary videos below and understand, because very soon the free internet and your access to knowledge of the truth will no longer be available, upon which time I predict we will enter a new and the last dark ages, as they have planned it. Unfortunately, unless you start spreading the seeds of truth, that dark ages will be 6 feet under. Okay, by now you must be thinking, I can't read any more of this trash. Well, here's where you should say that these are only written words, and if it's crap, then it makes for great entertainment and can't possibly affect me. So are you going to go on and seek the enlightenment of truth? Just think the rest of your life you'll wonder what you missed if you do not continue on. It's your choice. I would like you to understand that I do not write to convince you of anything. My writings are not about me, nor are they for any selfish reasons. I want you to think for yourself. Truth is love. So I am only sharing and giving love. Okay, it's time for me to tell you what the first corporation created was and why it was created and what it has done to the evolution of humanity. Do you know what the first corporation was? It was the creation of the privately and secretly owned Federal Reserve Bank in the USA. Yes, this is a private corporation and is not owned and controlled by the people. immediately after its creation another thing was created. That is the Internal Revenue Service. Then the public was told that they had to pay a tax on their labor to this Federal Reserve. Please know that this IRS was never ratified and is not lawful. There is no law that says you have to pay income tax. The people were never made aware that there has never been a law passed in the USA that says you legally have to pay this tax. But that's not the worst crime of all. The worst crime in human history is giving a secret society the ability to now create money out of thin air and go about taking over and controlling all assets of the world. How do you think the Federal Reserve note became the world reserve currency? Are you now beginning to understand just how huge this crime is? I doubt it. Please read my "How Can You Be Taxed When There Is No Tax?" article to better understand. The people have been spoiled by the proceeds of this crime. Society has been bought off with an easy, luxurious living while the crime continued to grow. As they say, the root of all evil is money. So just follow the money to see what evil they do with it. If you read my "Are You Ready for the Truth?" article, you'll get a really good understanding of the results from this truly horrific crime. I have always said that if the future of mankind is not guided by the truth, then this planet and all living things are doomed. So are you going to arm yourself with the most powerful weapon, that being the truth, and join the truth revolution by becoming a truth soldier? Jesus was a truth soldier. Ever notice that his cross is a T for truth? Because God is the truth. God never told us to sit idly by and do nothing and not fight against evil. Those who do nothing to stop the evil are just as evil. That line in the Bible, "God forgive them for they know not what they do," is a forgery. In the old original writings, it actually said, "God forgive them not, for they know what they do. The end is near." Reader's comments. Charles Kafka says, "With your permission, I would like to put this into my notes section. Of course, giving you credit. Great deal of research. Well done. Thanks." Charles Kafka says, "Updated. Everyone is waking up." Daniel J. Towsey says, "Do you remember these? Forget them at all our perils. Truth, justice, and liberty. In God we trust. Equal rights. Your basic international human rights. The right to pursue happiness. The right to life, liberty, and freedom." Yes, you may repost and email and copy and download any of my writings. You make copy quotes as long as you also provide a link back to the original article of truth. Only exception is that corporations are not allowed. Thank you. Charles Kafka says, "Yes, these days post the Declaration of Independence and you are on the terrorist watch list. Hell, come home as an Iraq vet and you are on the same list." Lori Meeker says, "Thank you. I wish people would actually read this. But ever since the microwave was invented, which I really wish I had one. By the way. And love them in their convenience. But I digress, people can spend more than 30, 40 seconds on anything before their attention spans begin to wane. How can we get more people interested in anything that requires more than a 15-second sound bite? Brother, I will march beside you if you just tell me which direction we are supposed to be going." Daniel J. Towsey says, "Lori, you are so right. I long ago realized the challenge. I and many others face and trying to get the sheeple to stop chewing on that corporate newspaper. Every time I try to feed the sheeple from the produce of the seeds of truth and try to yank that newspaper out of their mouths, the sheeple always just baa at me, ha ha ha, every time I try to feed them some truth. Yes, their attention spans are so short and their vision is so narrow. They can only focus on that corporate media little screen for little minds. Thoughts why most of my Truth Soldiers articles are very short. But even that little bit of food for thought just leaves the sheeple shitting themselves. Sorry. I have to say it. I am here just laughing while trying to type this. I guess the only answer I can think of for the sheeple is the only language they understand. Bah-ha-ha-ha. Lori Meekerade says, well said. Sharon Swanson says, very nice summary. Thanks for the input. We all appreciate it. We are looking forward to more truth. Always. Clyde says on December 13, 2010, thank you again for sharing. Daniel, I'll have to check the links out a little later because I'm behind in some of my other studies, but I'll be back. Danieltowsey says, Clyde, be sure to share this info. Clyde says, will do. I was checking out your other site and sent you a friend request there as well. Looks like an ambitious undertaking, but that's the kind of in-depth research I've come to enjoy from your work. Thanks again. Grayskull says, great job, Daniel. Will take me a while to read and watch all of this. Thanks. Leonidas Merelitos says, I believe institutions exist to control the free thinking of people. It may sound crazy, but the more people that are ignorant, the easier it is for the institutions to control. Selena Jumpa says, Daniel, I agree that there are serious problems and most of them stem from the corporation as an entity. But when you give false info such as the first corporation was the Federal Reserve, it discounts the rest of what you are saying. To be clear, the Federal Reserve is actually a private bank that loans money to the United States government and not an actual governmental body. As most people think, it has a board of directors and is owned by a bunch of rich white guys. This much is true. But the first company that existed that was treated the way modern corporations are treated, power, wealth and all, was the Dutch East India Company in the 1600s. They issued stock and worked much like a multinational company does today. Except the Dutch allowed the company to wage wars, establish colonies, imprison people and other activities that today's companies pay government officials to carry out so that they can save their profits for their executive bonuses. Daniel J. Towsey says, Selena, the word corporation never existed before the creation of the Federal Reserve. You stand corrected and I am the one who is correct. I never said that the Federal Reserve was the first company or business that operated in resemblance to what we now know as a corporation. Selena Jumpa says, the thing that distinguishes a corporation from a company is individual personhood. England had corporate lawyers and there were tons about corporate law written in the late 19th century. The Federal Reserve was chartered in 1913. Corporations legally existed before 1913. And in fact, the Federal Reserve is not generally legally considered a corporation because it does have portions of it that are public. So you can get all defensive at me for pointing out your one erroneous statement if you want. Or you can talk about how corporations are destroying the country and what we can do to stop it. Daniel J. Towsey says, find some proof for me of a registered corporation that existed before the Fed. Hi, do you have any links to anything about corporations before the Fed? And personhood came long after the Fed was created. And all corporations sell stocks and bonds, so they are part public. That does not change the fact that they are corporations. Even the USA government is now a corporation. Selena Jumpa says, Daniel, I am not trying to start a fight with you. I know you hate trolls and people who get into these groups just to start shit. I am not getting this info from the internet, but from knowledge I have outside the web. I read many of your pieces and agree with much of what you say. I am sure you can find links to this info if you want to spend the time. Like I said, I am not posting here just to start a fight, and I am not spending any more time on this. I apologize if I pissed you off. Like I said, to me it was just the one piece of info seemed wrong in the context of everything else you were trying to say, which was so valid. Selena Jumpa says, I know I said I wouldn't, but I am stubborn. In 1893, William Anderson wrote a law dictionary with an entire section on corporate law. Although corporation was not a typically used term, legally companies were referred to as corporations since at least then. Even though I know he has sources as well. I used to work in a store that sold antique books and came across this many years ago. Daniel J. Towsey says, I found this at Yahoo Answers. It is interesting and would mean that the title of my article should now be Creation of First Corporation to Take Over the World. Best answer, chosen by voters. It is claimed that the oldest corporation in the Western Hemisphere is the Harvard Corporation, founded in 1636. Harvard College, a component of Harvard University. Formerly the President and Fellows of Harvard College, also known as the Harvard Corporation, is the oldest corporation in the Western Hemisphere, founded in 1636. The second of Harvard's two governing boards was incorporated by the Great and General Court of Massachusetts in 1650. Tony Westover says, corporations are simply a tool, just like unions, that have existed for centuries. Trying to vilify the institution of corporations or unions is pointless because they're not evil. Evil implies intention, and a tool cannot possess intent. It's the user who has the intent. Corporations are simply a way for a group of people to share a liability. Unions are a way for people to collectively bargain. That's it. Get over it. Daniel J. Towsey says, thank you, Selena. So this is going to be my new subtitle line. To take over the world, worst crime in human history. Selena Jumpa says, that sums up the Fed pretty well. Philip Guerrieri says, early 1600s, at the same time that the King of Kings was distributing his Bible at the rate of 1,000 a day to the Puritan pilgrims that would come to the New World, and at the same time bring England down in that gory, glory 30-year war that brought England into the King James Empire of the British and then in the New World. King James became known as the Holy Ghost Corporation with no physical body. say parent but equal? Since Abraham Lincoln opened Pandora's box, corporations have been enthroned. An era of corruption in high places will follow, and the money power will endeavor to prolong its reign by working on the prejudices of the people. Until wealth is aggregated in a few hands, and the republic is destroyed. Abraham Lincoln, commenting on the rise of the corporation during the Civil War, shortly before his death. It is now the end.